Welcome to FitViews Podcast. What you hear in this podcast are ideas and opinions. Nothing is intended as medical advice, as I am not a doctor. I'm just a chick with a mic. Always check with a qualified and hopefully knowledgeable health or fitness professional before changing your diet and fitness routine. As always, guys, you can support the show by leaving us a 5-star review wherever you get your podcasts, or you can check out our affiliate links in the show notes below. Episode 2 of our Getting Started series, Getting Started with Activity Tracking. In episode 1, we covered tracking our calories and macros. In this episode, we are going to discuss the other half of the equation, tracking our activity. Now, there are two parts to tracking our activity, tracking our workouts and tracking our overall daily movement. I actually think that tracking our overall daily movement is the most important of these two. That might sound shocking, it should be all about the workout, but by far, it's where I personally see the most benefit. So let's talk about that first. I recently heard about a study where they took people who normally get their 10,000 daily steps in every day and had them on purpose drop themselves to 2,000 steps a day. In just 2 weeks, researchers started seeing their health markers edge into metabolic derangement. Yikes. Personally, I know if I'm gaining weight or stalled trying to lose weight, the first place to look is at my daily steps, because that's usually where the problem is. I can be doing everything right, hitting my macros, hitting my calories, getting my workouts in, and I'll be in a stall. And if I check my daily steps, get those in line, stall over. So how do we get started tracking our daily movement? Well, first, you're going to need an app. A lot of phones automatically have this ability, or you're going to want to get a step counter of some sort, a fitness tracker, or a reliable pedometer even. Now, I am not one to have my phone on my person at all times. In fact, I don't even know where my phone is half the time. So for me, a fitness tracker works best. Next, just like with food tracking, I highly recommend getting a 3-day baseline before making changes. Make sure to include a weekend day and try your best to make zero changes and completely ignore the numbers during your first 3 days. This will give you the most accurate baseline to start from. Now that you have your baseline, aim for improvement every week. Everyone is different, and instead of just immediately jumping to the generic 10,000 daily steps, it's a much better approach to start at your baseline and work on adding 500 to 1,000 steps each week. So if you're only getting 3,000 steps a day, I've been that bad in the winter, then your first week aim to get 3,500 or 4,000 and work your way up until you find your sweet spot, depending on your goals. If your goal is just good health, I think 10,000 steps is a good goal to aim for. See how that feels for you. I have found that 10,000 to 12,000 steps are perfect for me when I'm maintaining, and 15,000 to 17,000 steps are what I target for weight loss. Now, those are just my numbers. I have a pretty tough time losing weight, and that's my sweet spot. Yours will likely be different. Track for a while, do some tinkering, and find your sweet spot. As far as trackers go, you can get from very basic to all the bells and whistles. I am currently still using my Garmin VivoFit 2 that I got, 4, 5, 6 years ago when I worked on a campaign with them. I have loved that little thing. I've used it like crazy. I don't think you can buy them anymore. I believe they are up to the VivoFit 4 now, maybe. I'll leave a link below. But what I really love about the VivoFit 2 is that it's got a regular watch battery, and you don't have to lose time charging it. I've also heard good things about Fitbit. A lot of my friends have them, and I gave my oldest son a Fitbit Charge 2 a few years ago. Shop around, read reviews. Most of them will have apps that will have all kinds of fun charts and graphs. And I know the Garmin app has challenges that you can start and do with your friends to keep each other motivated. It's really kind of fun. So now that we've gotten aware and mindful with our overall daily movement, we can start to look at workout tracking. If this stresses you out, skip it. Like I said before, daily movement kind of trumps everything here as far as good results, no matter what your goals are. Let's face it, if you're getting in a workout, gold star for you. But if you are a data geek like me, or if you just want to try it out, I say give it a whirl. There are tons of options when it comes to workout tracking, from super basic to super high tech and detailed. The most basic option is a paper journal. There are tons of great options out there. I'll link to a couple below in the show notes that I've tried and liked. If you're a runner, I love the Believe journal. When you're looking for a fitness journal, keep in mind what particular workouts you tend towards and you want to do. Many are geared towards specific workouts like running or strength training. Also, definitely make sure that they leave you room to write. I've seen many journals that just have these tiny little spaces and there's just not enough room to track, say, your miles or your pace or your distance on a run or the weights and reps and sets on your strength training. So you definitely want enough space to write and make notes. Pre-made fitness journals can be great because they give you the prompts and the little spaces of what to keep track of, but you can also just use a bullet journal or even a blank spiral notebook or even a big calendar. Things you might want to track for your workouts: date and time, type of activity, duration of activity, intensity of activity, was it an easy workout, was it a strenuous workout? So I usually just do like low, moderate, intense or something like that. Calories burned if you have a good watch. Just be aware that the numbers that are on the gym equipment are usually wildly off. Workout specific things like miles and pace for running or reps, sets, and weights for strength training, things like that. It's also good to journal a bit about how you felt. Did you feel strong? Did you feel weak? Did it feel amazing? Did you feel like Wonder Woman? Were you dragging butt? Did you take a pre-workout? Did you not sleep enough the night before? Useful notes like these that you can look back on in learning what works best for you. The next step up is an app or fitness watch app combination. If you're already using something like MyFitnessPal, they usually all have a section for you to log your daily workouts, and most of them will sync with your workout tracker apps to add your daily steps or your workouts automatically. Just a note on MyFitnessPal, I'm not sure about other apps because I really haven't used any other apps, but they usually add back in your workout calories at the top in your goals for the day. So for example, if your daily goal is 1800 calories and you burn 400 calories in a workout, it will give you 2200 calories for your goal target for that day. I ignore this. I set my goal being mindful of my normal activity levels and find I usually stall if I listen to this recommendation by adding back the workout calories. Now, most calculators that you'll use online to set your macros and your calories will ask for your activity levels. So if you set it to, say, 3 to 5 workouts a week, then that is already figured into the total they give you. This is especially true if you're seeking fat loss as your goal, but it's also true when maintaining. It may be different if gaining strength, gaining muscle is your goal. As far as fitness watches go, I've had a Garmin in the past, and that was really great for runs. But if you're looking for a multi-sport watch with a pretty accurate gauge of calories burned per workouts, I highly recommend getting a Polar. I've had 3 over the years, and they're just the best. I'm currently using a Polar M430, which I'm not sure if they still sell. It's a few years old and a bit thick. The newer ones are getting more sleek, and I would definitely recommend checking them out. My affiliate link is, of course, below. Most of their watches will double as your step tracker too, so that could be nice to just have one watch instead of 2 like I have right now. The app even syncs with my Fitness Pal, so I don't even have to enter my workouts or daily steps when I use my watch. Now, workout watches are absolutely not a requirement. They're just kind of a lot of fun. If you enjoy the data and like to track all these fun, crazy things like I do, then definitely check them out. Some things to look for in a fitness watch: GPS if you're a runner or a cyclist, wrist-based heart rate for the most accurate calories burned, and let's face it, a chest strap is just annoying. Other than that, there's all kinds of fun bells and whistles depending on your goals. They can track your sleep, your pulse ox, your recovery. They'll give training recommendations. They'll do the dishes. Okay, they won't do the dishes, but they're really a lot of fun. So this is definitely an investment that should last you for years. So shop around, read reviews, and pick one that you love. And I think the best part about a fitness watch is it automatically does all the fitness tracking for you. It records your workout, your heart rate, your calories burned, your time, all that stuff, plugs it into the app, plugs it into your tracking app like MyFitnessPal, and it's done, and you can just check it out, learn, adjust, go from there. Like I said, if you're a data geek like me, go for it. If this all, however, stresses you out, skip it. It's all just useful information in figuring out what works best for us as individuals. Workout tracking should be a tool in becoming aware and more mindful as we work towards our goals, not a stressor. So how about you? Do you track your workouts? What do you use? Tweet me. My Twitter link is in the show notes. Don't forget to join us for FitViews Book Club over on Clubhouse. Links for more info below. Thanks for listening. See you next time.